I'm Mort Cooper, your host on Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. If you wake up in the morning and you sound like that, do you feel comfortable being who you are? That's Walter Brennan. Give or take a tone and a note or two.
You're happy, you're having a good time. I hope that you, if you woke up with Mr. Rogers' voice, where would you be?
A famous person? We're going to talk about famous voices. And your voice. Are you happy with your voice?
Is it everything you like it to be? Would you want to trade it in? Do you think it's taxing on you?
If you had Woody Allen's voice, where would you be? I don't want to say it right now, but many of us would have problems because Woody Allen is a very uncertain guy, and he works very well on the stage in the movies.
But if you say, I don't know if your insurance really covers, I don't know if it covers, if it doesn't cover.
And what if you had Andy Rooney's voice?
I don't know about you. And answered the phone like that. You woke up like, if you were Andy Rooney's voice in the morning, I don't know about you.
What would you do? Would you be happy? What if you had Dr. Ruth's voice?
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. Knock, knock. Would you be in deep doo-doo? I don't know. It depends on where you are, who you are, and how much your voice is worth to you. How much is your voice worth to you? When you answer the phone and you speak with, this is James Bond, 007, does that get you heard, liked, and listened to? Does darling, darling, darling Ronald Coleman, all these years I wanted to hold you in my arms and tell you how much I love you. Does that make your day? It makes a lot of people's days, the women in this country. They go gaga over the English accent. This is the BBC Home Service. They love to listen to English voices. Why?
Why don't they like to listen to New York voices? Are you coming home for dinner, Harry? What are you going to do, Harry?
Why don't we have voices like those famous people, give or take a notch or two, a tone or two, and have a voice that really characterizes us? Do we have that in our voices? The ordinary folk, the people who work the phones, who work in the factories, the people who are students, who are truck drivers, not only lawyers and doctors. If you listen to a lawyer sometime, yeah, I think that's right, we can take care of that. It sounds like the mafioso. If you listen to the doctor in the bedside manner, well, of course, you know, he could put you to sleep if you're not awake. You're not all there.
I don't know about you.
I love Andy Rooney, but 3 minutes, Andy, is enough.
Mr. Rogers, is your mother home? Are you having a good time? I'm very glad. He does that number for years and years.
Very good for kids. Let's talk about famous voices and your voice. Now, when you wake up in the morning, do you have the blahs? Do you sound like you're not ready to face life? Most people have the blahs in the morning. Johnny Carson calls it the grumpies. Johnny's been there, he knows, and so have you and so have I. We wake up in the morning and we're half dead. I don't mean half awake, I mean half dead.
I don't know about you. Andy Rooney would say it that way. Mr. Rogers, when you get the grumpies, you hear that voice right up there, goes right up your back, like a nail on a blackboard.
Then you have the mayor, the former mayor in New York, Koch. Now, his voice.
I ain't talking like that.
Is that the voice that goes with the territory? Do New Yorkers have to have that nasal twang in there?
Does the Midwest have to say back all the time? I'm going back to Chicago.
What's wrong with those people? Why can't they be more like 007, James Bond? Why can't they be more like Ronald Coleman? Darling, darling, darling. Why can't you have a voice that really turns others on?
Now, you've heard yourself on tape. I know you have. I call that the sound revolution. When you hear yourself on tape, you say, I can't be me. There's something wrong with the tape machine. Knock, knock. There's something wrong with the tape machine. But what's wrong with the tape machine? There's nothing wrong with the tape machine. Do you know what's wrong? It's something wrong with your voice. And you're saying,
I was born that way. That's the way I was born. I can't have a famous voice. I can't have a good voice. I can't have a voice like 007. That's the way I am. Harry!
Now, if you believe that, I say if you believe it,
then you're going to stay with that infamous voice. It's not going to be a famous voice. It's going to be a kind of infamous voice. It's like voices that are tuned out, turned down. People don't want to listen to you.
You've noticed people who look at their watch when they hear you talking. They have places to go and people to meet. Why? If you had a voice that turned people on, they wouldn't want to go anywhere. They'd be late for their appointments. But when you wake up in the morning, do you have that voice that says, I'm here, and I think you'd like to listen to me? All these years I wanted to know you, may I have to tell you how much I love you. Charles Boyer, where did those voices come from? Hey, baby, who loves you? Who loves you? Telly Savalas, hey, baby, who loves you? Yeah, yeah. Right up here in the mask. Now, is that how you get a good voice? You talk up in the mask? What is the mask? That's what you're saying. Let's talk about voices and how they get to be the way they are and how you can do it for yourself. Because if you wake up in the morning and you're talking like that, do you want to talk like that on the phone? Do you want to talk like that on the phone? Do you want to sound like Stallone who's playing Rocky Balboa? Yeah, that's the way to do it. Do you want to talk like that? Do you talk like that? Why can't you sound like Mike Wallace of 60 Minutes? Why can't you sound like somebody who is somebody? And you are somebody. But when you talk, do you come across as being somebody?
Do you sound like that?
Do you sound like a nerd? Do you sound like a blah? Do you sound like a dinosaur? Someone in the past? A dodo bird? Are voices around us dinosaurs? And if they are, why can't they be better than they are? Not better, better. We always say better. B-E-D-D-A. You feeling better? No. I'm feeling better. From New Yorkies, we've all been infected with that virus. You're feeling better? How many times do you hear that expression, better, B-E-D-D-A? Why do people do that? Why do people have such unfamous voices? In a sense, infamous voices. Let's talk about it. I don't know about you, but I know about me a little. Some time back in time, I didn't have this voice. I had a different voice,
a nasal voice. This is Morty Cooper. Testing 1, 2, 3, Morty Cooper.
And I tested my voice on a tape machine and it came across, I thought I'd sounded like James Garner or the great voices of our day, or Laurence Olivier and Gil Good. I thought I had a great voice when I was a young kid.
And it came back testing 1, 2, 3. This is Morty Cooper on the tape machine. Now the secretary told me, Cooper, from Brooklyn College, Cooper, it's a brand new tape machine. And I told her, listening to my voice, that the tape machine is broken.
So she put her voice on the tape machine. And her voice came back as nasal as it was, because she was nasal. And she looked me straight in the eye and she said to me, quote,
you're right, Cooper, the tape machine is broken. It's not my voice. And that's the way she was talking. That's the voice that came back on the tape machine.
So I knew. It's called the moment of truth, and you have that when you hear yourself played back on a tape machine or a message replay.
And you're talking like that. You sound like Dr. Ruth.
Now, Diane Sawyer said Dr. Ruth on 60 Minutes as the most unforgettable voice. It's not only unforgettable, you can't understand what this lady is saying. It's worth a fortune. It's a trademark voice. It's like Joan Rivers. I was privileged to work with Joan to help her to get that voice. And people are always saying, are you crazy? That voice, you help? Yeah, I was paid very well to get that voice. Why not? We need a trademark voice.
I feel that the situation that we have in the country.
If you understand what Henry Kissinger says when he's saying it, you win the prize of the year. I always feel I'm losing my hearing when I hear Henry talk.
I feel that the situation that we have.
He's been in the country for 40 years almost or more, and he still has that German accent. He probably goes to the Berlitz School to keep the accent, but I love to hear Henry. I have the feeling his batteries are wearing down and out. But Mimi Van Doren on the Merv show said no, his batteries are not worn down and out. She knew, she said. She dated him. So the voice doesn't represent us all the time. Does your voice represent you? And you're talking like that. Do you feel like that? And you're talking with a funny voice. Why don't you have a voice that really says something about you instead of talking now, ladies? Have you ever heard Julia Child? It sounds like somebody pinched her rear end. A pin may have popped. Now, ladies. It gives you the jump. It has a jump start voice. Why do you have a voice that when somebody hears you, they say, is your mother in? Is your father in? Respectively. Because you have a kid voice. Why do they say they can't understand what you do? Because you mumble, you boy. They ask you to repeat yourself. Why do they do that to you?
I don't know about you, Andy Rooney would say.
But I do know about voices. And voices are very strange instruments. They seem to play havoc with us. We never take a single lesson, as Andy Rooney would say. He does that number with his face. We never do a single, we
never take a single lesson on the voice.
But that's true of Andy Rooney. That's true of Dr. Ruth. That's true, probably, of Mr. Rogers.
Is your mother home? Are you having a...
And Woody Allen, he got that nerdy voice. I know you like Woody Allen. I like Woody Allen very much. I like Mr. Rogers. I like Dr. Ruth. I like them all.
I like Andy Rooney.
But I wouldn't be around those voices too long. Why can't we have voices like Ronald Coleman? Why can't we have voices like Charles Boyer? All these years I wanted on you in my eyes. Why can't we sound like 007? Why can't there be a 007, a Mrs. 007? Why is there only a James Bond 007? Have you heard Brenda Vaccaro? Have you heard voices? She used to have a great voice up there. I've heard her for a while, down in the lower throat. It could be a famous voice. There are people here in town that sound like they're gargling on their voice. They seem to like it. Gives them a trademark sound. Maybe you're one of them. Does it make your day to have the voice that you have? Why don't you have a famous voice? Why don't you have a voice that really speaks for you, that says something about you? You wear clothes to represent yourself. You try to make yourself somebody has status and power and give yourself a little air here and there. You have to inflate yourself a little. It helps, you know. We don't want to make fools of ourselves all the time. We don't know too much about what we're doing, but we don't want to say that. We're too proud. You know what I mean. Now, people who have those funny voices, they talk right up here in the nose. Do they have to do that? No. What can you do to change it? Ah, I thought you'd never ask. This is a program dedicated to the mask. The mask. The masking of America. The buzzing of America. You see, 007 talks up here, around the mask, around the lips and nose. The voice is built on a megaphone basis, from the top of your eyebrows down to the bottom of your fifth and sixth cervical vertebrae. Michael Jackson, you see, here in town, when he talks, he always has that charming English accent. And he always sounds so self-possessed, so in charge of things. And he may not be on the mark, but his voice is always there. And it's always charming to hear him as 007. Now, why can't you have 007 or Mrs. 007 or Ronald Coleman's charming tones of yesteryear or Charles Boyer all these years? And even if you have an accent and you come from New York, why can't you sound like Who Loves You, Baby? Why can't you be another Telly Savalas? Why can't you be a Ms. Telly Savalas, a Mrs. Telly Savalas? Why do you have to shriek, Harry? Why do you have that voice? Because you don't know how to focus. That's why. Now, what does that mean? Focus? Why don't you get your voice focused?
What's he talking about? What's he talking about? You're focused up here.
Remember I told you. I said it just a few moments ago. But it passes us by. You haven't had a single lesson on your speaking voice.
So you talk up here in the upper one-third of the mask. You see, the mask is a blend of oral and nasal resonance around here, the lips and nose. You're talking up there in the upper throat.
You want to make the sound a little more oral. If you say right, if you say really, if you use buzzwords, right, really, do, go, you're going to energize your voice. You want to energize your voice if you have that nasal sound.
Now, some of the famous voices talk up there, and they energize it up there. They're on the 30-yard line.
You knew who that was. You heard it once. You didn't hear it twice. Once is enough. It's like some people say, I told you once. I'm not going to tell you twice. When you hear a certain voice, you know where it's coming from.
It's coming right from the schnoz up there. Jimmy Durante used to say, you got to talk more in the schnoz, or that's where he's singing from, wherever it is.
That's true, but some of us have too much schnoz. So you want to bring it down and make it a little more oral and blend it with the oral resonance. One, two. I call that the humming of America. You can hum your way to a better voice. Does Andy Rooney want to change his voice?
Nah.
Does Dr. Ruth want to change?
Nah.
Does Woody Allen want to change his crotchety voice?
Nah.
Do you want to change your voice?
I think maybe you should. Maybe you should.
All the world is queer, save thee and thee, said the Quakers. And lately, I have doubts about thee and thy voice. So let's try to change the voice that you have. Would you bear with me?
Because I used to talk up there,
and then I had well-intentioned help. I talked all the way down here and lost my voice. I sounded like Henry Kissinger before Henry was there without the accent. I've been through 12 MDs. I talk about it. And I didn't get any help. I finally ran into somebody who did know about the voice. And that's how I got into this field. And that's why I'm talking to you about your voice. You can self-help. You want to try it? The voice has got to be blended over here. You hum your way to a better voice. Oh, there are those who tell you you have to posture your head, you shouldn't cough, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that. You should change your personality, you should change the way you think. I say poppycock to all of that. Just change the way you're using your voice. You don't want to change your personality because you're driving the car a certain way. You want to know how to drive the car. You want to know what is right and what is wrong. With a speaking voice, to get the sound that's really you, that star quality, you simply need the right direction. And all too often, you've never had that right direction. Now, why is that so? Because between the ages of 12 and 15, when you change from a boy to a man, from a girl to a woman, from a kid to an adult, you don't change your voice. 50% of us, I estimate,
talk too high, too nasal, too thin, too nerdy. How are you? You're doing fine? You feel good?
We sound like we come from left field. Now, why don't we change that? Because we don't know we can get a better voice. We really believe, you believe, that the voice that you have is the voice that you're going to live and die with. That's wrong. It's a myth. It's a long-lasting myth.
So you talk up there, and then you hear,
all these years I wanted to hold you in my arms and tell you how much I love you. Darling, 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 hey, who loves you, baby? You hear great voices. You hear James Garner, Anne Bancroft, Cheryl Ladd, and you love those voices. I've been privileged to work with some of those stars. And I could tell you that you can have star-quality voice. And if you have trouble with your voice, laryngitis, hoarseness, difficulty being heard, voice goes out and fails, you don't have to have that. If you use your voice properly, the voice will go on and on and on like Bob Hope. And his voice is right up in the mask around the lips and nose. Now, if you talk all the way down here, you're going to lose your voice, in my opinion. You can get a condition called the strangled voice.
I can't talk.
Well, your voice comes and goes. The medics will tell you it's neurological. They'll tell you it's gene-related, possibly. I won't tell you that.
I'll tell you that it's a voice problem with psychological overtones that has an excellent prognosis, an excellent chance of changing.
It's the same way of changing from that voice, if you have that,
to changing over here, if you have the right direction. But you have to want to do it. Now, do you want to get a better voice? Do you want to sound like Anne Bancroft, Diane Carroll, Cheryl Ladd? Do you want to sound like James Garner? Do you want to sound like Peter Jennings? Do you want to sound like Dan Rather? Not so much Dan Rather. Maybe we'll take Walter Cronkite. Do you want to sound like some of the great voices of yesteryear and today? When you hear people on radio and television, you say, it's amazing that voice doesn't go with that person.
They talk like this on television, and they are very appealing, very handsome, and they're very, very attractive, men and women. And they sound like Harry, Harry.
Now, why do they do that? They look so attractive to us, but their sound is infamous. You hear it on the news, and you see it in person. And you got to go because it's time. See, you got an appointment, right? I'll make you a wager. If you had a voice that really said something about you and was good, like James Garner or Anne Bancroft or Kirk Douglas, people would stay around and listen to you, and they wouldn't go anywhere. Now, Andy Rooney, I don't know about you. I think Andy will do it for us in about 3 minutes, and I love Andy Rooney. But that nasal tone has got to be one of those sounds that's right out of New York City. He fits right in. I don't know if he comes from New York City. Andy is a great sound. And you have that sound, too. But can you afford it?
Andy is a trademark voice, if you know what I mean. You know what I mean.
He's a trademark voice, and it works very well for him. But when you say hello, I'm going to ask you this. Does your voice say goodbye?
You talk on the phone? You sound like this?
You talk like that?
You talk screechy?
Why can't you have a voice that gets you heard, liked, and listened to? Even if it's a trademark voice. Well, you don't have the real guts to sound like Dr. Ruth. That's what it really is, in part. And you don't want to sound like Mr. Rogers. Is your mother home? So you lower the voice all the way down here, and you talk like this, and you're losing your voice, and you wonder why you go from one doctor to the other, and they tell you it's just something in the genes. It's neurological. You know what I mean. And they tell you to take potions and lotions and shots and all of that and rest your voice. I don't go for that, you see.
I believe if you put your voice up in the mask around the lips and nose, if you buzz there, if you hum, one, two, you might find that your voice lasts throughout the day and it has a great sound. It sounds rich and full and open. And you're going to say, I was born with the voice I have.
I wasn't born this way. I used to talk like this. This is Morty Cooper. And then I had two well-intentioned college professors at Brooklyn College put me all the way down here. I talk like this. So I lost my voice. That's how I got into this field. Some people call it a racket, if you know what I mean. It can be a racket. I'm a voice coach, so you can't help yourself. But I'm saying, why don't you get a voice that you like and people like to listen to? Do you want to talk like that all the time when you wake up? Why don't you sound like Anne Bancroft, Cheryl Ladd, James Garner?
I have a couple of books that been out for a while. Change your voice, you change your life.
You change your life if you change your voice?
Yeah, I think so. And it's in the 11th printing. It tells you how to self-help. Self-help, that means that you can do it for yourself with the simple techniques. And because business was booming, we came up with another book, which is also doing very well. It's called Winning with Your Voice, 5 minutes a day to a more effective voice. And why not? Why don't you get a winning voice that really speaks for you? Are you there? I'd like to hear you get up in the morning and sound so good that when people hear you on the phone, you don't have what I call the grumpies that Johnny Carson calls it, or the morning voice when you sound like this. They say it's a pleasure to talk with you. Instead of, did I wake you? Did I wake you? Have you ever heard people, when you're
answering the phone at 2, 3 o'clock in the afternoon? Did I wake you? Or whenever it is, did I wake you? Do you have one of those voices? Why don't you get a voice that really says something about you, that represents your personality? Hum, hum the first bar of Happy Birthday. They call me the Happy Birthday Man. Because I always suggest the humming of America. If you do it, your voice basically goes up into the mask. Now, there's another thing. You take your finger, put it at the bottom of your breastbone, and it's called the Cooper Instant Voice Press. It's named after me. Why not? Everybody names something after them. And you go, ah, and your voice basically is anchored. It comes out in seconds. So if it's too high, it comes down. If it's too low, it comes up. Why don't you get a better voice? Why don't you have a voice that really says something about you? Instead of having a voice like that. Instead of sounding like, Harry. Because you don't believe you can do that, do you? And I'm saying, why not? And I'm going to say something else. Most of us aren't born with natural voices. They're developed. The people that you admire in radio, on stage, television, in the movies, the ones that have the good voices, are not born with them, per se. They develop those voices. And it is my view, you have that option too, to have star quality voice. If you do a lot of that, if you're clearing your throat, you have trouble being heard, your voice is failing, you're a voice suicide. You don't have to be that way. You want to get your voice up here, and it gets you heard, it gets you liked, it gets you listened to, instead of talking up there and talking down there. I don't know about you, but I think you can get a better voice. I'm Mort Cooper, your host on a program called Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. Why not? Why didn't you try it too? I'll see you next week. Good night.